like seeing whales as well. It's an absolutely thrilling experience. I think we just need to really be respectful in how we do it. So I'm Carrie Toskey. I had the great opportunity to work with Luna. When we saw Luna up off the west coast of Vancouver Island alone, it was a very different situation. He didn't have his family group, but he was seeking interaction. When we're lucky to see whales in the wild, it can be a whole different thing. Getting what they need, and what we need to do is step back and watch that from afar. Luna's family is part of ELPOD, which is the Southern Resident Community, and they are listed as endangered both in the U.S. and in Canada. This is from a bunch of factors: reduced numbers of prey, high toxic levels, and a lot of interactions with soldiers. But think of yourself if you go into a really busy restaurant, you're trying to order food, and it's so noisy. You can't communicate what it is you want to get. It's taking a long time. Your stress level starts to get high. That may be what it's like for these whales when they're trying to catch food, and there's lots of boat activity. You know, if you see whales in the wild, you know, things you never want to do, you never want to get close enough to try to touch them, try to feed them. You don't want to get in the water with them. This is their world, and you really want to be watching from afar in that respectful, quiet place. And not just Southern Resident Killer Whales, whales all over the world need this type of respect. And there are certain guidelines and laws that your community has or places that you're visiting have posted. So if you're on the water, it's your responsibility to know those and follow them and be whale watchers. As a boater, if you were to come across whales, I think probably the best thing to do is to slow down or stop. Get a really good sense of where they are, and then you want to move out of their way. And you want to stay to the side, nice and slow. Always be ready to adjust your course so that you're not getting in the way of those whales. Let them make the choices of what they want to do with their life. So when you kind of have that moment of thinking, oh, I just want to get a little closer, think about what that might mean for the whale, and instead move a little bit further away. For Southern Resident Community whales, as well as other whale populations in the world who are struggling. And there's all kinds of ways people can join in and help. And that's not just how you behave on the water, but it's all the choices we make in our daily lives. There's really nothing like seeing whales in the wild. It's an absolutely thrilling experience. And knowing that you have not at all impacted them in this space is really rewarding, and it's beautiful, and it's, you know, it's what we're all seeking.